So back to this. Good morning. It's been a difficult one. It's oh my gosh, that is funny. It is funny when the person from before, I know I put on pink and everything because he probably remembers me fat. So I'm here thinking. Well, yeah. That was a fun relationship in my life, actually. It went on for like 6 months, and it was extremely puritanical. I don't even think they have that type any longer. Perhaps it's like an illegal place. Yeah. So I'm like when you have like a day like this, and I'm like thinking all of this discussion over, what was that last video? Yeah, I'm scaring my cartoons here, and I've got to drop, and so it's turned me into like this multi overtasking thought thinker that I can't do the dancing, the yoga, I can't even draw, I can't sing, I can't upload something here of my website there. It's just freaked me out. There's so many things, you know, and it's just there's one issue is mind-boggling. So I have to bring it down because it's not fair to the cartoons here. Yeah, not fair. And so I guess so. I'm gonna deal with the fat of pink today. We'll talk about the fat of pink. And I guess it's necessity. We have to have it. You can't throw pink away. It's an odd color, isn't it? It's one of the weirdest colors I know. Oh. Yeah, I'm trying to think, you know, in real nature, you know, real nature, before genetically modified or hybrid, where is the pink in nature, you know, aside from, on a butterfly, is there a pink there? There might be a few. It's pretty unusual though. So it would be probably around animals that are near more rose quartz, you know, as their mainstay vitamin. Yeah, pink isn't unusual. I'm thinking there's not really a pink sheep. No, there's no pink sheep. Oh, I'm in my office, by the way. Oh my gosh, I had scorn on my face for how long? Did you see it? Oh my gosh, scorn. Anyway, so back to my old girlfriend there that I had from the childhood, and she is like, what? She put up some, I don't know, I'm sorry, that was an ugly drawing, and take it off, it's terrible. So now I have to be her boss all of a sudden. She knows it. I mean, did you forget your password? Just remove it, you know. I'm not gonna go and write on the site and find the comments. I'll just tell it right here. Just take it off the internet. It's hideous. Have you gone mad? Have you overtaken too many poison mushrooms? So yeah, we don't want to see ugly like that. I'm tired of looking at all this dang ugly. There's way too much ugly flooding this, what people call art. And it's merely representation, it's a bad angle, you know, it's everything. And she knows it's ugly, so why did she put it there? She's a beautiful woman now, so why is she going back to, maybe she was an ugly child or felt as an ugly child? This is just stupid. I don't want to see your Van Goghian self when you're 3 years old. So anyway, I wanted to talk about pink. So there is pink as this washed out red passion, you know. It's an emotion of washed out red passion. You know, what is it stirred into romance and passivity actually. It's supposed to be passivity and yet there they are. There are the criminals there going flip out 20 minutes in, you know, wearing the pink suits. As soon as they put them in the pink suits, they start getting aggressive. So, yeah, maybe not too much pink in the painting here I'm making. It's not really a painting, but yeah, maybe not too much pink. Oh my gosh. So does that mean everything? Like, don't over sneer on your face. You know, don't show those gums when you're sneering. Yeah, that'll be a good lesson. I was gonna write to my teacher for a minute, and then I'm like, oh gosh, if I start writing again and again, I'll be like, oh, she's trying to take over. She's one of those types. She's a student who's over bossy. She's trying to make herself over important, and she doesn't deserve it. So I won't write to him today. Gosh dang it. I know it was just a really snippet. It was just gonna be funny. It was just a joke, you know, about me scaring my cartoons and so over my frustrations. Even over pink, for example. Yeah, when you add one color too heavy into a drawing, you know, you end up frustrated. It's like, what the heck? And so then I'm like out releasing all of this energy back into the world, you know. So being an artist is not necessarily a pacifist place to be, that's for sure. There's nothing passive about it. It's not a rainbow collective. Am kind of hungry also. Mama fast for like ever, I think. I'm enjoying it. I don't. I'm really tired of food. Food is really just. It's just not been helpful for me. It's just been a real mean enemy, a real mean enemy. And gosh dang it, I wore flannel. I wore gosh dang flannel, you know, blue flannel for those 6 months. And I don't think that was helpful in that relationship. Pale blue flannel. It had a little pink in it also. It had a little pink. But that was a funny one. Strict guidelines. We had strict guidelines in the same bed. Very funny. As one of my most favorite people in the world, actually. When I think of my life, you know, all the people I go through, and he's always one of the ones that stands out as a favorite. Hopefully, he didn't become a heroin addict in the middle, you know. But I guess he could have. There's nothing wrong with that, you know, but I guess, you know, it could get difficult trying to leave such a habit. I don't know. So alcoholism was a, I guess my biggest fear for him was alcohol. You know, did he go alcohol way? Because I think we were drinking heavily at that time. All of a sudden, you know, big, hey, we're grown adults, let's start drinking alcohol. Yeah. Probably to drown our sorrows of my blue flannel pajamas. blue and pink.
Yeah.
So anyway, there. So what is he now? He's a dance teacher or something, maybe. Yeah, maybe dance teacher. I thought he was performing still in I thought he was in Béjar. There's a guy in Béjar that looks like him that dances. So I thought he was there dancing in that horrible production. There's a terrible production of Nutcracker, a nouveau copycat of Behnert and Pierre Wyss's. I'm not really sure the deal why Béjart went copycat style. And he's like, oh, I'm the biggest copycat. I'll make this ugly Venus creature and put her out there. I guess so. I want to be the biggest copycat of all. Yeah, I thought he was in that one playing the drag man. So I'm a little confused if he's now in the United States. So yeah, he's kind of an old love of mine there. Yeah. Am I furrowed again? Yeah, I'm furrowed. Sorry. I know I'm too serious. I was too serious then, and I'm too serious now. So that was probably the biggest problem. I'm just staying too serious. You know? So anyway, yeah. I appreciate the gift, you know, from my mother. She bought me the flannels, those pajamas there. They're really good. They're thick. I think they're like the Pendletons or something, if they were a Pendleton variety. But no, they weren't Pendleton. It was another brand. They used to have a shop. They had a shop. It wasn't anything like Victoria's Secret. It was way before that. It was like a special one. Something and something. And they had all of these little doodaddy type of clothings, you know, for young women. And as you know, my mother just wanted me to stay warm at night. Just wanted me to stay warm. I don't know. Yeah, I guess that was, if you want to go back to pink, that Rembrandt of my lifetime, that was a pink moment, hey, a bring back. That actually was infuriating over time. Yeah. So. Oh my gosh, my goodness, way too tall for me also, way too tall. And this is another habitude of my de-successes. What is the deal? I think he's 6'3 or something. I mean, impossible. And yet, that it happens. Yeah, there's like, this is a freak show, Therese. What are you doing? It's a freak show. Yeah. And then I'm like, what is going on in the night in the mind? You know, what are we thinking about in our dreams together here, side by side, all these months? What are we thinking about? Yeah. Unbearable tension, some, like you can't believe it. Unbearable. I still feel it. I still feel it to this day. And so, I guess he's on the internet. Yeah, unbearable tensions. feeling of that kind of a hunger. What is that hunger? You know, when your stomach is growling, it is the same, you know, it's that same kind of attention. Very similar. So this particular dancer here, she reminds me of she's like a girlfriend from another boyfriend. I can't remember. Jolie, she was a pretty dancer. I actually never got to see her dance, but it looks like, it reminds me of her. She's very thin when I met her, you know, very thin, you know, typique thin. Yeah. So yay. Yeah, I guess so. So in a way, it's odd, you know, because it's like there's my mother. She's purchased this, you know, these beautiful pajamas, and I wore them, and they were so great, and they kept me warm. And yet, I guess so. I guess I had resentments. I carried resentment at those particular pajamas because they stopped me from. Releasing quite a bit of my anxieties. They kept me chained, actually, in. It was a difficult 6 months. Talk of a prison, you know. I think, everything increased. The drinking increased, the smoking increased, the staying out later increased. Just absolutely. So yeah, abstaining from sex is not actually always the best thing to do. Because you can destroy, your liver and run and start drinking Everclear. Yeah, and a lot of this is like, what? I have a girlfriend, you know, that is 500 miles away, and I have to stay pure to her. Those types of relationships. Those are bizarre. So anyway, thank you for that, heavy. See, I guess so, I've been carrying that heavy weight. That heavy weight of, I got a girlfriend, and it's very, very serious, and we're getting married. But I need the money, so I have to stay here and sleep next to you. Yeah, so I don't know. Yeah, hopefully he doesn't have problems with his own, like, self, physically, testicular, jeez, you know, I mean, I blame all of this garbage, you know, this garbage, I mean, that is absolutely a momente, you know, without the release allowed with it, where we end up just harboring all of these, it's a disease. A disease moment begin. So try not to endure in there and feel bad. Like you were a bad boy. That you even wanted me for a minute extra. So yeah. So anyway, I'm getting a little bit of a headache thinking about this.